Good morning, Sunday, September 22, 22nd, 2019, 8:01 a.m. 8:01 a.m. Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for your mercies are new every morning, God Almighty. Praise your holy name. We just lift up our day to you, our lives, our precious loved ones and friends, family, loved ones, our neighbors, neighborhoods, towns and cities, our country and the world, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Psalm 106, praise ye the Lord, O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. For his mercy endureth forever. Who can utter the mighty acts of the Lord? Who can show forth all his praise? Blessed are they that keep judgment, and he that doeth righteousness at all times. Remember me, O Lord, with the favor that thou bearest unto thy people. O visit me with thy salvation, that I may see the good of thy chosen, that I may rejoice in the gladness of thy nation, that I may glory with thine inheritance. We have sinned with our fathers, we have committed iniquity, we have done wickedly. Our fathers understood not thy wonders in Egypt. They remembered not the multitude of thy mercies, but provoked him at the sea, even at the Red Sea. Nevertheless, he saved them for his namesake, that he might make his mighty power to be known. He rebuked the Red Sea also, and it was dried up. So he led them through the depths as through the wilderness, and he saved them from the hand of him that hated them, and redeemed them from the hand of the enemy. And the waters covered their enemies. There was not one of them left. Then believed they his words. They sang his praise. They soon forgot his works. They waited not for his counsel, but lusted exceedingly in the wilderness and tempted God in the desert. And he gave them their request, but sent leanness into their soul. They envied Moses also in the camp, and Aaron the saint of the Lord. The earth opened and swallowed up Dathan, and covered the company of Abiram. And a fire was kindled in their company. The flame burned up the wicked. They made a calf in Horeb, and worshipped the molten image. Thus they changed their glory into the similitude of an ox that eateth grass. They forgat God their Savior, which had done great things in Egypt, wondrous works in the land of Ham, and terrible things by the Red Sea. Therefore he said that he would destroy them. Had not Moses his chosen stood before him in the breach, to turn away his wrath, lest he should destroy them. This is what an intercessor, a prayer warrior, does. Intercedes. Had not Moses his chosen stood before him in the breach, to turn away his wrath, lest he should destroy them. This is what an intercessor, the heart of an intercessor, okay? Because not everybody has arrived. Not everybody has arrived. Not everybody gets it right away. Sometimes it takes years, okay? Yea, they despised the pleasant land. They believed not his word, but murmured in their tents, and hearkened not unto the voice of the Lord. Therefore he lifted up his hand against them to overthrow them in the wilderness, to overthrow their seed also among nations, and to scatter them in the lands. They joined themselves also unto Baal-peor, and ate the sacrifices of the dead. Thus they provoked him to anger with their inventions, and the plague brake in upon them. Then stood up Phinehas and executed judgment, and so the plague was stayed. And that was counted unto him for righteousness unto all generations forevermore. They angered him also in the waters of strife, so that it went ill with Moses for their sakes, because they provoked his spirit, so he spake unadvisedly with his lips. They did not destroy the nations concerning whom the Lord commanded them, but were mingled among the heathen, and learned their works, and they served their idols, which were a snare unto them. Yea, they sacrificed their sons and their daughters unto devils, and shed innocent blood, even the blood of their sons and of their daughters, whom they sacrificed unto the idols of Canaan, and the land was polluted with blood. Thus were they defiled with their own works, and went a-whoring with their own inventions. Therefore was the wrath of the Lord kindled against his people, insomuch that he abhorred his own inheritance. And he gave them into the hand of the heathen, and they that hated them ruled over them. Their enemies also oppressed them, and they were brought into subjection under their hand. Many times did he deliver them. He's always there to deliver us. Right there, always. Just have faith, okay? Not just have faith, but have faith. You got to have faith at any moment of day, okay? Many times did he deliver them, but they provoked him with their counsel and were brought low for their iniquity. And I'm not going to add anything here, but they were in constant unbelief. Every time God would do something for them and do a miracle for them, then they went back to unbelief. Nevertheless, he regarded their affliction when he heard their cry, and he remembered them for his covenant, and repented according to the multitude of his mercies. He made them also to be pitied of all those that carried them captives. Save us, O Lord our God, and gather us from among the heathen, to give thanks unto thy holy name, and to triumph in thy praise. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel from everlasting to everlasting. And let all the people say, Amen. Praise ye the Lord. Father, we lift up this day to you. We lift up this day and our lives to you this day, Lord. Yesterday's gone. We forgive. Bless. We forgive. Forgive, Lord. We forgive. Help us to forgive. Help us to move on from yesterday. Help us to live in reality today, Lord. Help us stop holding grudges. We confess we have sinned, Lord. I intercede for the people as if I'm there too, Lord, and I have not arrived. So, Lord, I'm one of them, and I'm also one of the blessed that you have forgiven, that you hold not our sins against us because of Jesus Christ, your Son, who you sent to save us, to die on the cross for our sins. We intercede, Lord, for the masses of people, the hurting, the homeless right now. In particularly, let's get LA cleaned up, Lord, and helped. And San Francisco and New York, the big cities. And there's little towns with homeless, Lord. We don't forget them either, Lord. Have mercy, Lord. Father, we just love you, Lord, and we thank you for your power. We thank you for miracles, Lord. We have to believe in miracles, church. Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. If we don't believe in the miracles and that we have need of miracles, then we're really? We need them, okay? I confess I need God's miracles. I need miracles in my life, my own life. And so, Lord, I thank you for miracles, your miracle-working power to heal, to deliver, to set free, to bless, to pull up and out of the miry clay. Satan, we bind you. I bind you in the name of Jesus Christ. Satan, you are defeated by the blood blood and the cross of Jesus Christ, I resist you. I resist you on behalf of the people. We resist you in the name of Jesus, and you must flee. We thank you, Father, for removing the pots, Lord, removing the hardness of life from people. Lift people out and up, God. Father, bless businesses, bless homes and families and marriages right now. Hold people together, hold bodies together. Hold us together, Lord, and lift us up. Touch our president, touch the mayors and the governors, Lord. In the name of Jesus, protect our ICE agents, protect our border patrol, protect our police, protect our schools. We bind shootings in Jesus Christ's holy name. We bind terrorism in the name of Jesus. We bind domestic violence. We bind cancer. We curse it at the root. We bind it in the name of Jesus. We bind you, Satan, from stealing, killing, and destroying people. We bind you from wearing the body of Christ out. We bind you from making us weary. We bind old age diseases. We bind old age. Hey, Father, thank you, Lord God. We will resist that too. In the name of Jesus Christ, who said we were supposed to succumb to age. So we will do everything we can in our part, on our part, to be healthy and in shape. In Jesus' name, help people learn the techniques of stretching. To get on the floor, on the bed, and stretch the body out carefully. I'm not a doctor. I'm not a physical therapist. Disclaimer, I am a nobody, okay, in that area. But I encourage you to do these things, to stretch your body out so that you stay limber as you get younger, okay? I don't use the word old. I don't use it. You shall have what you say. The Bible says you shall have what you say. Why do we succumb to these things? Okay, I live in reality. I understand. Okay. Father, lift up the body of Christ, Lord, and the division in the body of Christ. I'm not even going to go there, Lord, specifics. I'm not going to go to specifics, Father. You know the division in the body of Christ. You know the division in America over politics and race and everything like that. Just, we should be so much farther, people. We should have come so much farther. What happened? Whatever happened, we bind it. We bind the cause of it in the name of Jesus Christ. So, Father, I thank you for this day. Touch pastors, touch churches, touch the body of Christ, Lord. There's only one church. Work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Work it out, Lord. Work out that division. There's only one church. We love Catholics and Protestants. Hey, we come against the cults within the body of Christ. We bind cultish behavior. Narrow-mindedness. Yes, stay focused on the Lord and read the Word for yourself. Stay in the Word yourself. Don't rely on your leaders. What's going to happen? God forbid, what happens when one of them fails? Or, you know, we're all, you know, imperfect. What's going to happen when you put your trust and your faith in a person or a thing, make an idol out of this, and then what happens? Keep your eyes on Jesus. Keep your eyes on Jesus. Keep your eyes on Jesus. When you go to the mountaintop and you get all excited about things in life, blah, 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 just remember that God told them on the mountain of transfiguration, to keep your eyes on Jesus and hear him. Hear ye him. Hear my son, God said. Okay, so I'm going to stop preaching now. Have a really good day, and God bless you. Amen. In Jesus' name, amen.